Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create stunning double exposure graphic portraits. Before we begin, if you're not already a subscriber to my channel, click that small subscribe button at the lower right corner to let you know as soon as I upload new Photoshop tutorials. Open a color or black and white photo of someone in which one half of the face is in shadow. I downloaded this one from Shutterstock. If it's a black and white image, go to Image, Mode, and click RGB Color and 8 bits per channel. If it's a color photo, we want to remove all of its color. To do this, click the adjustment layer icon and click black and white. To adjust its brightness and contrast automatically, click the adjustment layer icon again and click Curves. Curves uses luminosity to adjust the shadows, midtones, and highlights. Click Auto, which does a great job brightening our image. We'll convert our visible image into a smart object so we can continue to modify our subject non-destructively. Shift-click your subject to make all the layers active, and click the icon at the top right corner. Click Convert to Smart Object. Next, we'll crop our image to size and position it for our second photo to create the double exposure. Open your Crop tool and your list of crop presets. Click Width, Height, and Resolution and clear the width and height. I'll make its resolution 150 pixels per inch. Go to each side of the bounding box and drag them in until your image is sized and positioned to accommodate the second photo. Then, press Enter or Return or click the check mark at the top. To fit it back onto your canvas, press Ctrl or Command 0 or press Ctrl or Command and the plus sign to zoom it in incrementally. Open back the Curves adjustment layer. If you're unable to see the entire panel, just drag it down. Drag the input black point across to darken the midtones, and drag the input white point to the left to bloom out the lightest tones, which increases the contrast. Next, we'll brush in black and white. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer, and open your brush tool. If your foreground and background colors aren't black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. Open your brush picker. We'll adjust the brush size in a moment. Pick a soft, round brush. Make sure the hardness is 0% and its opacity and flow is 100%. Then press Enter or Return. To adjust the size of your brush, make sure your caps lock key is off and press the left or right bracket key on your keyboard. The left half of my image is already black, but I'll brush over it just in case there are areas outside of my subject that needs to be filled in. Invert your foreground and background colors by pressing X on your keyboard to make white your foreground color. Brush in white to fill in areas outside that half of your subject. Open a second photo that you'd like to use in your double exposure image. I downloaded this one from Shutterstock as well. To place it onto your subject's face, press V to open your Move tool and drag it onto the tab of the face. Without releasing your mouse or pen, drag it down and release. Reduce its opacity so we can see the face underneath it. To resize and reposition the second photo, open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. If you can't see the Transform's entire bounding box, press Ctrl or Command 0. Go to a corner, and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift and drag the Transform out or in. If you're using CC 2019 or later, just press Alt or Option as you drag it. To reposition it, go inside the bounding box and drag your image. Then press Enter or Return. Increase its opacity back to 100% and change its blend mode to overlay. If there are small areas of the face from the second photo that you'd like to remove, no problem. Open the Spot Healing Brush and brush over those areas. Make a copy of the second photo by pressing Ctrl or Command J and change its blend mode to normal. Click the layer mask icon to make a layer mask next to the copy and press B to open back your brush tool. Brush over your image to reveal back the face through the layer mask. Conversely, if you want to hide or mask out areas of the face, press X to invert your foreground and background colors and brush over those areas to reveal back the other photo. Next, we'll give our second photo a painterly look and then adjust its brightness and contrast. Make the top layer active and go to Filter and Filter Gallery. Open the Brush Strokes folder and click Accented Edges. I'll make the edge width 1, the edge brightness 36, and the smoothness 5. However, feel free to adjust these amounts for your image. I'll reduce its opacity to 67%. At this point, I'd like to darken the darkest midtones of the forest, so I'll click the adjustment layer icon and click Curves again. I want this adjustment layer to restrict itself to affect just the one layer below it. However, since adjustment layers affect all the layers below them in the Layers panel, I'll need to make this adjustment layer into a clipping mask. To do this, click the clipping mask icon or press Alt-Ctrl-G on Windows or Option-Command-G on a Mac. You can also go to Layer and create clipping mask. I'll drag the panel down again to see all of it. To darken the darkest midtones, I'll place my cursor on the diagonal line to approximately where the darkest midtones exist, and I'll drag it to the right to darken them. Lastly, I'd like to bring out the detail in the midtones, so I'll make the layer active and open my Dodge tool. I'll make sure the range is midtones and the exposure is 100%. I'll brush over the darker areas of the forest to bring out their detail. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.